cigarette because it's an addiction. You know, it's not because of what it looks like.
I don't think it's honestly going to work. People are still going to buy cigarettes. I think it's just another wasted policy.
Well, that's the very first subject that we're going to be discussing. Although I feel, as I look at the news pictures from Japan and the breaking news that nuclear radiation is 1,000 times above normal in the vicinity of the affected plant, that, well, events far, far greater than the ones we intended to discuss are underway on the other side of the world. But it is a debate that we are going to have because it is actually important for the place, the dear green place that we live, where there are no earthquakes or tsunamis, by the grace of God. We'll talk to Angal Karpal, first of all, shopkeeper, member of the National Federation of Retail News Agents, who's dead against the government's proposals announced today. And we'll be talking to Amanda Sandford, spokesperson for ASH, Action on Smoking and Health, who's, well, strongly in favour of the government's proposals and indeed wants to go further. So, Anjali Karpal from the Federation is up first. Anjali, thanks very much for joining us. Would you just summarise what your opposition is to these proposals?
Yes, I am really concerned about this tobacco display ban coming into effect because being a owner of a small convenience store, it's hard enough already. Life is very hard anyway without all these implications coming into effect.
But if it's hard, that must mean that people are going to be buying less cigarettes, in which case the government's policy is correct, no?
Not really. What are they going to do is they're just going to go to the supermarkets. So they will still be buying cigarettes. People are not going to stop buying cigarettes.
But the supermarket will have them under the counter and in brown wrapping too.
Yeah, but there is this confidence in consumers that in a small convenience store, we might not have all their brands because they can't see them anyway. So they might probably pop their heads, they can't see, and then they're going to go, oh, if there's a queue there, they're going to go, oh, maybe they haven't got it anyway. I shouldn't stand in the queue and ask. Maybe supermarkets will have it anyway because they're a much bigger place.
Yeah, but I really, if you don't mind me saying so, think that's a pretty semantic distinction. A much better point would be that consumers of a legal product have a right to see that legal product in the livery of the company that they have chosen as their cigarette of choice. That's a much better argument.
Yeah, they are old enough to know what they're doing, and who are we to tell them? You know, they know what they're doing. They're responsible adults, and if that's what they enjoy, you know, why not? Why should they be hidden from sight? And why should we try and tell them that, oh, we're going to hide it away from sight because it's bad for you?
Well, stay on the line, please, because I've got Amanda Sandford from ASH. Mm-hmm. Amanda, are you on the line there?
Yes, hello, George, I am. Good evening.
Now, summarise why you think this is a good idea, please, would you?
Sure. Well, we're in favour of the proposal because it's about protecting children. We don't, the measure won't have much impact on adult smoking, we don't think, because people know what brands they smoke. They will be able to continue to buy the cigarettes that they want. But we know that children are impressionable. They are influenced by the glitzy packaging, and they're more likely to have positive views on smoking if they are, you know, exposed to the very attractive packaging that is commonly on view at the moment.
So when do we put alcohol under the counter and wrap that up in brown paper?
Well, that's a separate issue. I'm not trying to fudge it, but to answer it fairly, tobacco is a unique product in that it's uniquely dangerous.
No. Alcohol is far more dangerous than tobacco.
I can
assure you it's far more dangerous than tobacco.
It has
a far greater negative impact in this society than tobacco.
I beg to differ because tobacco is, there is no safe level of using tobacco at all, whereas alcohol you can drink a small amount or, you know, moderate amount without coming to any harm. It's the abuse of alcohol which causes the problems in society, but with smoking there is no safe level. So as soon as you start to smoke, and because it's so highly addictive, people start smoking at a young age and get hooked very quickly. So what we're trying to do with these measures, by putting cigarettes out of sight of children, is to protect them, to dissuade them from starting, and just basically make it more difficult for children to start. And most people, even shopkeepers, are generally in favour of measures that dissuade children from starting to smoke. So
But children are not allowed to buy cigarettes in shops.
That's right. The law states that they're not, but unfortunately still many do, because sadly there are some retailers who don't fully abide by the law, or they find, you know, other ways of getting hold of the cigarettes. But, you know, I accept the point. It won't stop smoking completely, but it will help, and we have to have measures that will help to reduce smoking amongst young people.
Anjali, what do you think of what you heard there from Amanda?
Right, first of all, I choose to differ on this. Some retailers not abiding by the law, because there are restrictions in place for those retailers. They can be fined, which they do get fined, you know, and after a few warnings, their shops can be closed down. I'm in very much favor of that. And the other thing is, children don't start buying because they can see the packaging on display in a shop. Children start buying, start smoking because they've been introduced by their friends to smoking, or by their parents, or perhaps a girlfriend or a boyfriend smokes. This is the reason, peer pressure, where smoking does not start in a convenience store where children look at the packaging and they suddenly decide, right, I like that, so I'm going to start smoking from today. Smoking starts somewhere else, outside of a convenience store, not in a convenience store.
Amanda, last word to you.
Sure, I accept that argument. The main reason children start smoking is because their parents are smokers, or their friends or older siblings are smokers. But what the tobacco advertising does, and what we're talking about here is a form of marketing. Now that we have an advertising ban, you know, no more adverts on billboards or sponsorship of racing cars and so on, the tobacco industry use the packs themselves to market the message to young people. What the packs do is, you know, sort of make the smoking more appealing. And the industry have been very clever in making these packs appealing by putting them in sort of pastel colours. They even have, you describe some of the variants as super slim, you know, the very, very thin cigarettes are described as super slim, put in pastel packs, you know, that they've, in other words, to make them very appealing to young women especially in this case.
Can I come in here?
Yeah, go on.
Yeah, well, at the moment, if you look at the cigarette packaging, it says smoking kills. Mm-hmm. It says cigarette is bad for health, and all sorts of horrible messages written on the packaging. Also, there are graphic, horrible images of people with cancer and all sorts on the packaging. Don't you think that is better, what's happening now on the packaging, what's been introduced now, rather than plain packaging? But the thing is,
you can be sure, Anjali, that on the plain packaging, you'll still have those warnings, and you'll still have those horrific images.
But what I'm saying is,
that's why I'm saying cigarette cases must have a future.
Yeah, the thing is, that has not deterred smokers from smoking. People still ignore all that packaging, and they just go ahead and buy it anyway.
Okay, look, last word to Amanda.
Okay, well, what we would like to see, obviously, is the cigarettes put into plain packaging for that very reason, because health warnings do work. I mean, they have to be refreshed because people do, you know, ignore them over time, but they do have an impact. They do help to reduce child smoking. So we want to get away from the branding and have the health warning be the prominent message on the pack, and that's what we'll get if we have the cigarettes put into plain packs.
Okay, Amanda Sandford from ASH, Action on Smoking and Health, and Anjali Karpal, shopkeeper and member of the National Federation of Retail News Agents. Where do you stand on this debate? You can tell me on 08717 223344.